What's up, guys? Welcome back to Neon Trash. I'm your boy, Tommy the Hammer. Tonight, I thought we would check out a movie called Bubble, and this is directed by Steven Soderbergh. And I gotta say, I haven't seen a lot of this man's work. The only movie I've actually seen by him was a film called Traffic years ago in movie theaters. And I thought it was okay, but I also think it's high time that I actually give the man another shot and check out another one of his films. So I can't wait to check out the movie Bubble. You guys know this routine. Check out the trailer, peep that shit, and we get back. Y'all motherfuckers are gonna know my opinion on Bubble. Okay guys, so simply put, the movie Bubble is a portrait, a very subtle portrait into contemporary rural America. The characters in this film aren't necessarily relatable. I mean, some of them are, but ultimately, I feel like these characters are extremely realistic. These are people that I've seen before, people that I've known before. And if you go into any small town America, any city that's kind of stricken with debt and economic woes, then watching these characters unfold in this movie will be immediately recognizable. And it's actually quite sad because it makes you contemplate the suffering, the financial hardships of most Americans. And I found that to be kind of profound in this movie. At first, it kind of moves along at a very slow and snail's pace, but you know, they're really setting up these characters, and the acting seemed to be a little bit of scripted writing and improv acting, which I kind of liked. It made everything, you know, that much more organic and realistic and relatable. The main characters of this movie are an older woman named Martha and a young man named Kyle. They both work in a factory, a doll making factory, and for some strange reason, these two have hit it off in terms of a friendship. Initially, when we were introduced to these characters, I was kind of having trouble understanding why, they found common ground in one another. But as the movie went on, I started to kind of get it. Sometimes you don't pick and choose your friends, and depending upon where you work, where you live, and what you do, might decipher those around you. So I found that element to be immensely realistic too. Well, then this other character, a younger, you know, attractive girl named Rose, kind of gets interjected into the picture, and it kind of disrupts the relationship of this older woman and this younger man. The bottom line with this movie is it's kind of a crime story of sorts, and a very simplistic one. The music in the film is very minimalistic, and the dialogue takes center stage. You're meant to focus all of your attention on what these characters are saying, what they're doing, the place they're living in, their lives, the jobs that they have. Most of the people in this movie work in small towns, at a factory, and you know, some of them have to work two jobs. I feel like we're all, you know, stricken by financial hardships, and we're all, trying to, you know, give ourselves a better life. And, you know, ultimately, is that so bad to want to, you know, be able to pay the bills? I like the nuance of this film, and considering it was filmed in 2005, I feel like it's immensely relatable for Trump's America 2020. There's a lot of people I know today that resemble characters like this. And, you know, we're all going through horrible hardships in COVID America. And, you know, there's people that have lost their jobs and others that are, you know, dying from horrible viruses. And in this movie, the main focus is, you know, on people who are troubled, people who have, you know, mental disabilities. And I don't know, the connection between, you know, now and 2005, I feel like is apt. I feel like it's relevant. I gotta say, by the end of the movie Bubble, I was a fan. I liked it. And dare I say it, I got a little choked up for these characters. I could give Steven Soderbergh's Bubble a solid 6.5, strong 7 out of 10. So if you've never seen it and you want this kind of quiet yet bleak story about rural America, then definitely give it a shot. I found it to be definitely interesting. And you know what? It's a powerful movie in its own way. Until the next time, guys, tune in to Neon Trash.